The rush is not just a time. It allows me to move his hands and head out of the way so I can get to a leg. It also works as a good off-balancer, okay? Off-balancing this guy. And there's a lot of Greco technique that we're not going to get deep into that I'm not great at teaching anyways, but there's a lot of off-balancing Greco technique where we're really kind of gripping the shoulder now, okay? Starting to make this guy move. We're mainly concerned today, right now, on shoulder connection on top, all right? And getting this guy to move back and down, hands to the mat, all right? But what you notice is the harder you try to get this guy's hands down to the mat, and they kind of know that. They're thinking no front headlock, no front headlock. They'll take a big step with this lead leg to keep their hands from coming to the mat. That's like the easiest single leg in the history of Earth. Because they're stepping, but their hips are behind them, so there's not a lot of weight on the leg. Sometimes there is, because they're trying to keep their hands from touching the mat, but you'd be surprised at how much people fight that rush and pull and step in front to post to keep their hands up, and that single leg's just staring them in the face, right? And then you mix in the push, right? And then a little bothering them with the foot sweeps, right? We just got done with the slide-by foot sweeps. Playing with that guy, messing with his timing. When he starts thinking about no foot sweep, he stops thinking about upper body. Then when he stops thinking about upper body, we put his hands on the mat super easy. So elbows are tight here. Okay, punching in, my elbows are still tight. I'm pulling them down, and I'm starting to look to pull this wrist and slide below the shoulder into my single. All right, really simple. But we're not doing a ton of work, and we're not taking a ton of risk right here. It's not like I'm picking the arm up and then diving up under his body to his legs. I'm staying in a good solid position, pressuring in, shoveling snow, and then just reading that single. Getting it all the way outside up to my armpit. Don't worry about your finishes right now, but worry about snagging. Okay? And some of you guys that are a little bit better at this off balance and stuff, you can stand off balance. All I'm doing is I'm just putting my shoulder in the crease of his armpit. And kind of like I'm hyper extending his shoulder down to the mat. I'm not trying to break it, but I'm just turning. Boom, punch in. Go down, okay? Turn, punch in, circle down, punch in, circle down. That's a lot of work on his low back. That's a lot of work, and I'm leaning on him. He's carrying a lot of my weight. But lastly, when we start talking about this single leg, and I start pulling him down to the mat, he takes that big step. Below his shoulder. And if I try to shoot through his shoulder and he takes that leg back, now I'm fighting a pretty powerful part of his body. So as I bring him down to the mat and he steps, I just slide. Now I got his shoulder beat. Now I can come two hands to the leg. Super easy leg attack. Okay? Questions? Can you see it again? Pretty simple. Shoulder on top. Elbows to my ribs. Okay? Punch. I can off balance them too. Punch, shuffling snow. All right? Keep that pressure on my front hand. Shoulder beats his shoulder. Stepping, driving. I'm putting all that weight to his back leg so this leg gets light. Keeping the arm out of the way until I need to drop up to it. Okay? Good clean single finishes. Go!